All right, Vinyl Community, how's it going? I'm going to try to bring to you every single record I bought at the WFMU Record Fair a week ago in New York. Great times had. You saw my sort of video footage recap. Now I'm going to show you. I think I'm going to show you all the records I bought, and I didn't think I was going to buy this many after the first day or two, but by the third day, I stayed on budget. Didn't overspend on the budget, so that's good, I guess. But it looks like all told, I bought 54 records and 3 7-inches. Some of these will not stay in the collection. Some of these will be given to folks, it looks like. There's a few mistakes. Even though I was trying to be careful with what I bought, you know, fatigue sets in and you make mistakes. But I'm really happy with the stuff I've gotten. I have gotten to listen to a good, well, not a ton of them, but a good amount. Some. And, really stoked about all these. It's going to be fun going through them. And let's get into it. I mean, I want to thank again Brandon Faust in the head for driving. We were sort of, partners in the car. We stopped Friday on the way down from upstate New York at Hudson Valley Vinyl in Beacon, New York. A good friend of mine, Chris, runs the store. And it's a small shop. He actually shares it with another guy named John. Chris does a lot of the jazz and experimental stuff, and John does a lot of the rock and the reggae. And they sort of like divide and conquer that way. So we stopped there first. Right away on the wall was some great record, and by a band I've been looking for. Stunty has certainly championed them, and they're a band I've been aware of, but not until recently have I really explored their music, and it's hard to get. I'm going to try to go through these relatively quickly, of course, maybe talk more about them as I listen and discover them, but Pram, Sargasso Sea was on the wall. Pulled that down. This is the original pressing on Too Pure. And I also found at Hudson Valley Vinyl, a small shop, you can go through pretty quickly, the record we're listening to right now, For All It Is by Bar Phillips. This is the Japo pressing. Not a very expensive record. I kind of paid a little on the high side for this, but I got super definitely hooked up, so beautiful. This is a great record. J.F. Jenny Clark, Stu Martin, Barry Gee, Polly Danielson, Bar Phillips, double bass. This is from 1973. I also found this cheap Michel Portal for $10. Michel Portal unit, a Chateau Vallon, with Bernard Vite, Tamia on the vocal, Pierre Favre, and Portal doing all the reeds. This is on Le Fin du Monde. I'm sorry, Le Chant du Monde. Nice, fine for $10. That was on my want list, as was the Bar Phillips. Here's a mistake, one of the first mistakes. Not because I don't like this record, Brass Rockers, original Jamaican pressing by Tommy McCook. This is now going to be up for sale because I actually already have this record. Yes, I do. It is under a different it's with a different cover. I didn't cross-reference the cover. The price was just, I knew right away, great. And yeah, it turns out it's different title, different cover. I have the English pressing on Horse, or subsidiary of Trojan. This is on Total Sound, so this is good stuff. Clean Jamaican press. This will be up for sale. If someone's interested, let me know. And I also found the Bobby Naughton units. Understanding. This is not the Otik pressing. This is also on Japo. But it's pretty cheap either way. This is a good sort of modal. Not really free so much, but post-bop. But this is from 79. This one might be from 79. No, this one's early again. I'm wrong again. Recorded at Yale, 1971. So I did some trade with Chris there. I brought a few nice jazz records that he didn't have, and it worked out really well. Was able to walk out of there pretty relatively unscathed. Only had a cash out, throw over a little bit of cash. So we got to New York, met up with Frank JBL, and soon after that, that evening, Friday night, we went to Human Head, which had two different dealers set up doing a pre-show or sort of a preview show. Mind Cure, aka Fungus Books from Pittsburgh, and another dealer who I don't know his name, but ended up having a super grail for Dave, the VC ambassador, which I won't show because it's his record. I'll let him show it. It's on his way to him now. Before Human Head, though, I mean, we ended up running into Alex at Human Head. It was great to meet Alex, of course, Motorik 24/7. I'm going to show a record. We made a sort of arrangement. I'm going to show this now. I made a trade with Alex and some cash for the original pressing on Pills of the second Pulp of Vuh record in den Garten Pharaohs. Oh, I was looking for that. Beautiful pressing on the Pills label. A very clean, nice copy. So I traded a little bit of cash and Todd Dotsdotter on Owl to Alex. And this is a lovely record, the second album. I guess I am now collecting the Pulp of Vuh originals. I ended up keeping a Gira, so yeah. But lovely pressing, beautiful condition. Anyway, met Alex. We ended up making the deal on that a little after. But anyway, Alex made it to Human Head, and we hung out with Mazzy and Arnaldo, Jason, and some other folks. Frank, of course, was there. And Mind Cure had some nice records. This Chico Freeman, Spirit Sensitive, on Indian Navigation. This was a good price, and they actually gave me a pretty good discount, too. This is cheaper than the copy that's at Angry Mom right now, considerably cheaper, and then I got a discount. So into this one, already knew I wanted this. Cecil McBee, Billy Hart, Famadou Damoe, John Hicks, and Chico Freeman, Indian Navigation. This one is from 1979. The other one I got from Mind Cure, definitely one I hope to find. And I went for it right off the bat. About the average price it goes for, but then they did give me a discount. On Neutral Records, the first Sonic Youth LP, of course they have the self-titled EP, mini LP before this, but this is Confusion of Sex. On Neutral, nice shape, insert. And the record, of course. Neutral's Glenn Bronca's label. This is certainly Sonic Youth at their most harsh. So that was from Mind Cure. And then the dealer who was next to them, this was at the Human Head record store. I ended up not buying anything directly from Human Head, but this dealer had about three boxes of interesting stuff. This grail that Dave wanted, I bought for Dave. And this Ovary Lodge, this was in my want list on the Ogun label. I've sort of been loosely connecting the Ogun label. Ovary Lodge is a group with, of course, Keith Tippett on piano, harmonium recorder, Harry Miller, Frank Perry, Julie Tippett, sort of the English progressive jazz rock folks. 1976 on Ogun. This was, yeah, 25 with a bit of a discount. So that was Friday night. We hung out, had drinks out with Michael Notes and Tones, right? I didn't mention Michael, meeting Michael there, but he was there. And I was just gonna fast forward. You've seen some of the video footage, and so after waiting in the rain, Knockdown Center on Saturday morning, we got in. Wasn't thrilled with Knockdown Center and the way they sort of organized the event, but got in, wandered around. I did a quick scan for my grail that I'm looking for. I didn't see it. I ended up at the Billy's record salon table, but we would end up seeing that night. But I bought this straight away. Milford Graves, original pressing, of course, on ESP disc. This is still in the shrink. I don't know if I'm going to take it out of the shrink. I haven't even looked up to see which pressing this is. I have not gone through all the records yet. I'm doing that. I've done some of them. With Sonny Morgan. This is a must-have for the Milford Graves. Not that I'm really going to be collecting his heavy pieces necessarily, but bought this from Billy right away. Good deal on this with Sonny Morgan. And so, yeah, ended up next at a dealer who was called Deep Cuts, who has a record store in Brooklyn, and they had a really good mix of interesting, experimental, some rock, some jazz, a little bit of everything, but definitely seemed like sort of left of center stuff. He had, again, I have to compare and figure out, this is an original pressing, at least it's textured sleeve, I want to say it is, on the Shandor label of Dashil Hadiyat Obsolete. I had the unofficial pressing that Alex had nicely gifted me, so I've been wanting to upgrade this. I really do dig this progressive psychedelic, a bit of a Canterbury feel from the mid-70s. Awesome. Again, the price was right. Got a bit of a discount. All the dealers were mainly giving discounts, even on the first day. Maybe not as aggressively. Also, this Kupel, Graham Lewis, Bruce Gilbert. This is on the 4AD label, as you can see. Nice price on that. That was like about 20, 25. Here's one that was on my want list. Blam, blam, blam. This one is a New Zealand post-punk. It's really a bit all over the map. There's a bit of a Talking Heads feel to it. And it's a mini LP. It's their first sort of release, I believe it is, from 1981 on the Propeller label. Or is it Festival? I gotta check. It's Propeller, yeah. All from Deep Cuts. Right next to him was the seller Palto Flats. I bought an original pressing of, this was like $20, of Pounding Systems, excellent dub syndicate record. I have the reissue of this. I'll be selling that. We're just gonna fly through these, aren't we? I already forgot to say something about a different record. Anyway, I thought I was getting a super big score for $35 on this original pressing of the Le Chien de Noir, Théâtre de Chien Noir, Aurora. This was $35. I'm like, I know. I didn't even consider there being bootlegs of records on Futura, but apparently this is a boot. It looks legit. It looks like it's even from the era. I didn't know exactly what original pressings go for, but again, I didn't look this up. I didn't look up everything. I was going on feel for a lot of things. Stupidly or not, you know, I like to sort of, you know, I don't know. I'm like, you know what, for 35, I'm not sure. I know this thing sells for way more than that if it's original, but... And it does turn out it's like a $200, $250 LP if you find it. But anyway, it looks like this is a boot. More research should be done. We did play this at the Airbnb, and it sounds good. So, I didn't have that. I was waiting to find an issue. Right next door, Keith Fullerton Whitman. Founder and sort of runner operator of the Creole Poem label, the CD, a CDR label, as well as a musician and composer himself who's released records on Cranky, and he had a whole bunch of cool stuff. While I was looking through the Deep Cut stuff, Alex was right there with Keith and going through some heavy hitters. I ended up there next and bought a few blind buys and a few things I was looking for. Quandri Sonari, I played this briefly the other day. This is a RCA Italian promo. Just Keith had descriptions on everything as well. No, that's just the price. It was actually $20, not $30, but that's on the sleeve. So this was a nice one to try, and it really fit the bill. This one, another blind buy. I didn't know this. It's a Cuban record, actually. Daniel Viglietti y el Grupo de Experimentación Sonora Delicato. Delicacic. I don't know what I'm saying. Look at this cover. This is lovely stuff. This one we did play, I think, a side of. It's on the Arieto label. Cuban pressing. Ends the tapioca pressing. I would have liked it to be a pole pressing, but I was happy to upgrade my reissue of Fluence, featuring Pascal Comlade, as well as Pierre Bordes and Jacques Fournel. Oh no, that's, yeah, production and illustrations, but is it mainly Pascal Comlade? Anyway, this is the tapioca pressing that Keith had for a pretty fair price. And that was that. After that, I was talking with Frank, who showed me a cool French record he found at a French dealer, which would be set the tone for the next day or two. Frank brought me over there. And this is early Saturday, so just still figuring out what's going on. But realize, okay, this is some serious French stuff. The prices looked on the high side, but all French pressings of stuff, a lot of things I was looking for, a lot of things I didn't know. So what did I do? You phone a friend. Now, I don't have video of it, but it was awesome. Gave Stuntia an Instagram ring, and he was in a hot tub or a sauna. And I couldn't hear him too well, but I heard him enough to say, I flipped through all the bins. It wasn't a lot. It was like 5 or 6 bins. I think we did almost all of them. And he advised on a few I didn't know that I should grab. This one I saw, and I knew it right away. I did want to grab. Michel Portal, Splendid. Le Monde. CBS is a French pressing from... anyway, I was looking for this and I wanted this. I grabbed this right away. It was on the high side, but you know, this seller was also very willing to deal. Super, super aggressive discounts. And you know, you don't have to pay shipping, so it ended up being good. This is from a dealer who had consigned this exact collection of French records to Permanent Records in LA, and they barely sold, so here they were in New York. And weren't we happy to snap them up? This one, maybe is not quite as good as I thought it was. I was looking for a different JPM, Jean-Paul Massiera. But it's interesting, I need to listen to it some more. This is Phantasms on the Crypto label. A little more on the sort of disco vibe than I was ready for, but I gotta give it some more, give it a full listen. Grab that. This one I grabbed, Catherine Ribeiro and Alps P. Right? That's how I pronounce that French, my French pronunciation. P. Original French pressing on Philips. I had been looking for that. And these next few are all Stunty recommendations. I did not know these. Musique et instrument insolite. On the Daffy label, Sono Press, but it's by Jacques Lasry. Stunty recommend this one. A great inner gatefold there. Haven't played this one at all yet. This one as well, Pierre Bensouzan. Two. This one on the Sesame label. Digging into that. Did not know this. And this one either. Alex and Brandon both recommended this one too. Kohemic Ensemble, October 1974. This is a double LP. On the Le Chant du Monde again. And Hermeto Pascal. This is a French pressing of the Brazilian jazz fusion. Sort of progressive artist, big weirdo. So that was round one with the French dealer. I ended up at John, who was part owner of Hudson Valley Vinyl. We were there before. He had set up just himself at the table. He brought some of the records that we looked through, but I didn't see this one at the record store, so I bought this Junior Biles Jordan. This is Roots Reggae on the the Micron label. A little on the sweet side, but I did enjoy it. After that, it was a rainy mess. Then we got food. We couldn't come back in because of this goofy rule that they have. and Mazzy, Frank, Brandon, Alex, and myself, we ended up at a restaurant getting something to eat. And then we walked over in the rain to Brooklyn Record Exchange. And the night before, actually the first record I did buy was this Fact Tricks. We ended up going to this store the night before Human Head. It was on the way to Human Head. I forgot to mention this. This San Francisco industrial punk experimental group, Fact Tricks. There was a ton of records there. I mostly found stuff in the 7-inches and the 45s. So I bought this the night before. When we went over there Saturday, I bought two Jamaican 45s. I had a bunch of Jamaican. These were not cheap, but these were really great. There's Rockers of Augustus Pablo. Fantastic dub single. And this Lloyd Chalmers. I have a couple singles by Lloyd Chalmers I love. This is African Zuli on the Randy's label. So those are the things I got at Brooklyn Record Exchange. We did look through there for a bit. You saw some footage there. There was a bunch of cool stuff there, but mostly not anything I was really looking for, but the 45s, good stuff. All right, I'm going to find another record to play that and tell you about our trip to Billy's Record Salon. So I did just put on a little bit of this Hermeto Pascal, a musica livre, a musical book, the musical book of... Turn it down a bit. All right, so we're gonna finish up part one here, and part two will be a separate video, but we'll finish part one here with Billy's Record Salon. We all gathered, got some more pizza. We were eating on the cheap. Had some more pizza and met with the whole crew. We saw pictures, everyone that was there for the WFMU fair from out of town. We all met at Billy's, it was great. You'll see some footage at the beginning of this video. And I brought more trade for Billy, which he really hooked me up with, but yeah, it was great to be there. Billy was serving drinks, he had cookies, Alex was DJing, there was chess being played, lots of hanging and talking and vibing and showing records to people. It was just a great atmosphere. I think Billy set it up in that way to feel loose and feel like it's an exchanging of ideas and records, and yes, it is a store, but I think his focus is on it being like a good hangout place, a good place to sort of, you know, a community space even. That said, he brought the records that he had from WFMU, plus all his other stuff that was in the store, and I'll show you what I found. This one was at the WFMU Record Fair, but I decided to get it. This was one of the more expensive records I bought, even though this was very cheap. Well, like the lowest it sells for. Doug Hammond with Karen Joseph, Ellipse. It's a duo. This has got some super sick breaks in it. Love the drumming on this, which is Hammond with piano and voice as well. Karen is doing flute and alto flute. This is on the Idibib label. I guess this is Doug Hammond's label. So it shows wear, but like I played through this at the store and it wasn't bad. I mean, it does not look good here in the light, but these marks weren't bad. So it was considerably cheaper because of that wear, but it plays well. So I was happy to find that. This was one I've always just wanted to find, and I figured I would at some point. We listened to this back at the apartment. Portsmouth Symphonia plays the popular classics. Of course, the orchestra that's not trained, and that sounds like it, with the Eno testimonial on the back, produced by Brian Eno, conducted by John Farley. It's fun. Original Sub Pop pressing of the Rapture, Out of the Races Onto the Tracks. Absolutely love this EP. It's one of the only thing, well, really the only thing I wanted from the Rapture that I didn't have. Some absolute fantastic dance punk on this. This is the black vinyl pressing. There's a white version too. Just happy to find that. Also, Max Romeo and the Upsetters. Warren of Babylon. This was about $40. Original pressing on the Mango label. Also, the Acting Trio. I bought it. There's a bunch of original BYG actuals and when I found this weekend. Acting Trio is Philippe Maté, Andre Maurice, and Jean-Pierre Savard. French pressing original. And that was what I found at Billy's. Again, it was a fun time. We got dinner, late night dinner after that. And I traded with Billy, and it ended up being pretty reasonable. Traded two nice records to him. The dealers weren't really having it. I have a regret of missing the Gary Higgins Red Hash. I wanted the main guy wasn't there, and it was early in the day Saturday. Original pressing. And the dude working was like, yeah, I don't know if he's going to trade, but you can check with him when he gets back. And long story short, I went back a little while later and someone had bought it, so the price was right. Anyway, that was my regret from Saturday, but lots of great records. I got another pile to show. We'll continue that in part two. It's going to look the same because I'm going to keep going, but you'll see this in part two Sunday at the WFMU Record Fair with more Record Shops hit too. So stay tuned for that.